Hello and welcome to another episode of Blast to the Past. Today we celebrate the 4-year anniversary of Destiny. Destiny is a game developed by former Halo creators Bungie. In fact, Destiny was originally teased back in Halo ODST with an in-game poster that at the time went completely under the radar. Finally, after several more hints and teases along the way, Bungie officially announced Destiny on February 17th, 2013. Over the next 18 months, anticipation from fans and critics alike built until finally, on September 9th, 2014, Destiny launched. The game was launched to some very mixed reviews. While some people immediately fell in love with the game, myself included, others were disappointed by its incoherent story and confusing endgame leveling system. One thing was very clear. There was definitely something great here. People were annoyed, but they were passionate. Over time, Destiny launched its first two expansions, again receiving mixed reviews, and it was clear that they weren't quite adding enough to the game, and some overhauls were needed. However, there was a shining light to be found in amongst all this. Despite poorly representing its story in-game, Bungie released story through the Grimoire cards online, and many of the Destiny YouTubers were able to make a lot of great content with this, collating it and bringing Destiny's story to the masses. And with that story, Destiny's universe finally began to feel so much more alive. A year on from the initial launch, and Bungie released The Taken King. And this is where I think Destiny really changed. They overhauled some of the clunky systems, they introduced a whole new area, they made the story a lot more coherent, and they brought in the raid, which featured probably the game's most flagship villain to date, Oryx, the Taken King. Finally, Destiny was turning into the game people had hoped it would be. From here came the April update to add some more content, before in September 2016, Rise of Iron launched. Again, they added a whole new area to play and a new raid, seemingly putting the days of very light DLC behind them. After many rumors that Rise of Iron would be the last expansion, Bungie officially confirmed it was releasing Destiny 2, a game that would overhaul a lot of Destiny's systems and promised a story that was told in a much better way. The anticipation was that Destiny 2 could finally be the game Destiny 1 was meant to be at launch, and a fresh start for the Destiny universe on next-gen consoles. And then on September 6th of 2017, Destiny 2 launched to far more favourable critic reviews than the original. And while some people gave up on Destiny long ago, those of us who have stuck by it continue to be overwhelmed with its charm, and we're passionately anticipating each new release that awaits us in the future. Anyway, that's it for this week, Guardians. Please leave a like if you enjoyed the video, and subscribe for a whole variety of gaming content from new releases to retro classics. Until next time, I'll see you later, oh watcher mine.